Oh, whoops. That's right. If this was the WWE, which wrestlers would we be?
I don't know, because I don't know anything about the WWE. Oh, that's Papa Smithy's thing.
Oh, you're right. I should have that conversation with him. I'm sure he's shouting things at the computer right now. Zed Bands, Azir Bands coming out.
And the RE. So typical Bands against Mickey. You take away his ability to make the plays. So Lulu, bit of an interesting band. But Spenno, remember, is a team that has run the Juggernaut in the past.
Yeah.
And I think that that's what they're trying to get rid of right now, because that is something that we have seen coming back a little bit again with the rise of Kog'Maw and the TF. So three mid lane bans by Spenno, one so far by Anarchy. There's so many pocket bans in this game that we are going to get some big time power picks slipping through this draft.
Oh yeah, but they probably won't be in the mid lane. That's how it's looking. I wonder if we're going to see that Kalista slip through, because that's the thing. Do you ban the Alistar and give it to Secret? You ban the Ryze. Okay, so the Kalista will go through, but I don't know, man. I feel like you should take the Alistar, but they're going to grab the Kalista anyway.
So will they take the Ezreal early? I mean, it's probably just going to be Braum from Spenno if they lock this Ezreal in.
Yeah, I would think so, and there's Ezreal.
You have to take the Ez, though, because Sossin has been great on that champion. No, you don't. What am I talking about? Anarchy actually forced SKT to flex the Ezreal when they picked it because Mickey plays Yasuo in the mid lane.
Yeah.
You could absolutely give that up and just get Mickey Yasuo. Interesting.
True. Now, what are we going to see? The Rek'Sai would not be too surprising for a catch to take. He oftentimes does play that champion.
Okay, no Braum. How are they going to deal with this Ezreal if it is in fact a mid lane pick?
Yeah, no kidding. I mean,
they do have the Annie. That helps for sure. That does help lock down the Ezreal if you have to.
If you can get close enough.
Yeah, if you can get close enough, which you can with Flash. That's not going to be too big of a deal as long as Nuclear and Secret don't totally whiff on that engage.
The ability to block that True Shot Barrage, though, is really something, though, that you can't kind of understate as far as how good it is at handling this mid lane Ezreal. So, I don't know. Maybe Spenu kind of calling Anarchy's bluff and saying, all right, we thought you maybe were planning on flexing it anyway, so we're not going to go for the Braum, but I don't know.
Going to take the Lucian here. So a strong laner into the Kalista. This is the first time we have seen Kalista on 5.13 in Korea. It's been banned every game. So they, of course, changed her damage, lowered it by 10% on her autos, which is a very interesting change to make to the champion. So definitely not having that same power early on in the game. But they changed her AD scaling and all of that, too. So
yeah. Now, I wonder if maybe we would see them just send that Annie to top or something, because I feel like in mid you just get wrecked by Ezreal hardcore. They can't go with this Alistar. Can they?
I would love to see a mid lane Annie against this Ezreal.
I would too,
because you can't run cleanse, but it would be a blind pick. So I think they're going to try and take the Irelia instead, something that can get back onto the Ezreal. And Sossin going to show us yet another champion. Mickey has played mid lane Ezreal. Nope, Victor.
Oh, Victor.
Or Irelia, rather, but it's going to be Victor. So something that, if they can get back to Ezreal, will be very effective at 100 to zeroing him. They do have some pretty decent engage between Equalizer and Tibbers.
Sure enough, Maokai wouldn't be a bad choice there. Could grab the Hecarim, though, to just try to jump on to Kalista and Annie here.
Yeah, very good pick if he can get through the laning phase. We don't see much Hecarim these days because he just doesn't exert enough early game pressure because he's very item dependent. But that has been a champion that Ixu has gone back to time and time again this season.
So will he lock it in? How do you think the Hecarim would do against this Rumble?
Oh, he'll have problems early for sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, the Maokai going to be less item reliant and more reliable. And Ixu's been playing Maokai and Hecarim both all season. But
yeah,
Hecarim, again, if he gets behind, he starts to have issues. Maokai is much more reliable, even if you get behind in the laning phase. So that will be seen as the safer pick. So Lucian, see a few Lucian games here and there. Usually just a matter of picking for that lane strength.
Yeah, I feel like there's a lot of A lot of pick potential on Anarchy's side as well, too, as far as like getting in, grabbing somebody, and bursting them down really quickly.
Indeed, and there's a nice siege. Ezreal and Lucian together in the mid game should be have some pretty good ability to take down towers early.
Yep.
Meanwhile, Spenu going with a very meta composition. We'll see how this Kalista does here in Korea. They do have that Kalista Annie combo, which is a very high kill pressure lane. So Songyun and Snowflower going to have to be a bit careful. We'll see if the Kalista changes lead to some differences in itemization here.
It really is like a very heavy positioning emphasized team fight for both teams, isn't it?
Yeah, it certainly is. And Spenu should have some, if they get standard lanes, they should have a nice advantage. So we'll see if that comes through for them. We'll see how well Sossen can roam on the map. Of course, Ezreal will be pushed in. And if Sossen can get that tower, he may be able to open things up.
That's right. Well, here we go. Spenu versus Anarchy, game one. Let's see who takes it. Alright, welcome to Summoner's Rift. Spenu Sonic Boom versus Rebels Anarchy. You're on a very rainy, humid, and hot Friday. You don't move to Seoul, South Korea for the weather, that's for sure.
Hey, you could live here probably 5 months of the year and the weather is beautiful. Or,
yeah,
you could just move south, move to Busan.
I mean, I came from Minnesota, so I guess I can't complain. So it was worse there, I admit. Ooh, shenanigans coming in for Anarchy. A little bit of deep warding, perhaps. Oh, they're going to get that one.
Get some auto attacks down.
Yep.
Looking for that invade. Oh, time to hide.
If you put the mask over your face, you can't watch the game. Yep. Some early scouting being done by Rebels Anarchy. It's going to be interesting, too, because as you look at these two teams, I feel like Iksu, Lyra, and Mickey are probably the stronger ones on Anarchy. And I feel like Sossen, Nuclear, and Secret are kind of the stronger ones on Spenu. So you've got kind of this weird dynamic where the opposite roles tend to be the more powerful ones on each side.
Yeah, that's true. I think Soul and Catch definitely weaker than their counterparts. And
yeah.
Nuclear and Secret, I mean, Snowflower and Songyun aren't really big slouches, but you might be able to give Nuclear just a slight edge in that situation.
I just think Nuclear and Secret have more playmaking ability, you know? They just seem mechanically a little bit stronger to me.
Yeah, and especially Snowflower, when he's not on Thresh, hasn't had that same level of dominance. Well, we are going to see an early Gromp take here by Anarchy. Nothing on the side of Spenu, so fast level 2 for the Anarchy dual lane. They really don't want to be bullied out by this Kalista and Annie combination.
Well, they should be able to do plenty of bullying themselves with this Braum Lucian lane as well. Secret Nuclear just taking their sweet time, taking these early minions, it looks like.
So, yep. And that we'll see how well this translates to an advantage. Again, Snowflower does like to leave the lane and roam quite a bit. Mm-hmm. Means Nuclear and Secret might have some great opportunities for an all-in onto Songyun. Snowflower going to have to probably calm down with his roaming in this particular game.
Probably.
So, when we've seen this matchup before, for example, with Faker playing into the Runeglaive Ezreal with a Victor, what he likes to do is just shove super hard early, chip the tower, take the tower, and just keep somebody bottled up right at their tier 2 and start roaming and making plays on the map. Now, Sossen will have the opportunity to do that. He's got some great damage in his dual lanes, particularly in bottom for some diving potentially. That's something to look forward to here. If you want to contain the Ezreal, you really don't want to go even in the laning phase. You need to keep him on his back foot through a large amount of the game.
Yeah, very true. The catch will just be farming a little bit at the red buff. And here we go, Snowflower already going on a bit of a roaming mission here.
Yeah,
just looping around to do a little bit more damage to Secret, I guess, but seems like a good way to leave your AD carry vulnerable and miss XP to me.
Well, they were level 3 while the other duo was level 2, so there's that factor to it. That was why he was able to get away with it without one of them just getting all-in.
Wow, Nuclear, 100% win rate on that Kalista. And here's a gank on top lane. Soul in a little bit of trouble. There's a knock-up. Soul, can he get away? Already burned that flash. Doesn't look like it. and Soul very low, and who's going to get the first blood? It will go over to Lyra.
Yeah. Pretty aggressive pushing forward right there, and if you're doing that on the Rumble, it's about having your jungler there to back you up. If he wants to push forward on Rumble, he has to tell Ketch that's what's going on. Ketch has to get into the lane on the top side so that if a gank occurs, you can easily counter gank. So that was a very predictable gank coming in at about 4 minutes from Anarchy.
Well, Ketch running in to take a little bit of the enemy jungle, so at least he's able to strike back just a tiny bit anyway, but
yeah, there's so much kill pressure in that lane, though. The Maokai and the Gragas make it very easy to set up ganks.
Yeah. Oh, nice blocking from Snowflower. Saw that stun come in from Secret and got right there with the shield. And yeah, I mean, Ketch just has kind of had a history this season of not really ever being in the right place at the right time.
Well, he just has to coordinate with the Rumble. That's as much of a mistake from Soul as it is from Ketch. You have to be in calm saying to your jungler, hey, I need to push forward right now. I need you to back me up, because that's just how Rumble operates as a champion. So easy first blood for Lyra. Now, Spenu has actually built up a very large CS lead in this bottom lane between the AD carries. So Songyun, it's like he's having a very tough time laning against this Kalista. If you're going to pick Lucian these days, you'd better be picking him for his laning phase.
Yeah.
Because you have to get ahead for him to be very effective, which he can do, and we've seen it work against Sivir, we've seen it work against Corki, but there are better AD carries to select if you want to go low economy on some of these AD carries. He catches up with that wave, however, so he's not too terribly far behind.
Well, Lyra is going to be spotted by this ward. Nice position for that ward, actually. Not hiding that in try, so they'll still be able to use it. Ooh, Soul. I think you can see him. Oh, no, there's a ward. Aha.
Well, he's been discovered now. It's dropping that trinket ward right away, and that'll be maybe two wards cleared, actually, with the Raptor buff from Lyra. It's like he did get that second one.
Yeah, the pink ward couldn't see it initially, but the Raptor buff did reveal it. And with the jungler spending so much time on the top of the map, though, it really has given Nuclear a chance to be very pushy in this lane, but Songyun started to catch up, so that might not last forever.
Yeah, it might not. So 400 gold, really the only difference right now. The measure of that first blood. And we do see Mickey choosing the Ranger's Trailblazer first before getting the Sheen, so really wanting that wave clear. And now Sassen goes back on Victor's, starts to upgrade his Hex Core. And this is where the pushing begins. And a lot of this for Spenu is going to come down to how well Ketch can control the map, because Victor is going to be pushing up to try and deal with his Ezreal. They have to have good vision around the mid lane for Sassen. You can see Sassen goes back and buys both a pink and a green ward to help deal with this.
Mm-hmm. Songyun and Snowflower being a little bit sneaky in the brush, but not a big mystery where they are. As they reveal themselves nearly a level 6, though, I wonder if they're going to go all in on this. The way they were walking up made me wonder if they're about to hit it. But nope. Probably a smart idea to go for that Ranger's Trailblazer for Mickey, just to keep up in wave clear a little bit easier against the Victor.
Yeah, he's tried to steal the blue buff with the True Shot Barrage. Unfortunately for Mickey, it wasn't low enough to actually take. He only got some damage down on a catch. That was about it. And now Soul is returning into the top side. Ever since that gank, he's falling a little bit behind in terms of that CS on Rumble. Not going to be the end of the world. Lyra gets an early invade here. Oh, Lyra, this is really dangerous for Lyra. He's just gonna recall right behind the red buff right now.
Sassen could just come down and intercept him, though, but it doesn't look like Ketch is gonna find him. Not quite.
He was very dead there if he was found.
That was definitely a dead Lyra. But as is, because he wasn't spotted, that could be a bit of a mystery right now for Spenu, just where exactly Lyra is at the moment.
Well, Lyra was replaced by the Euro, actually.
That's right.
We know where Lyra is.
I thought it was strange that he named himself after an old Italian currency.
We'll see what happens the next few years, though.
That's true.
Euro may be going away. Uh-oh.
Oh.
No. 50
nearly
HP.
Stole it.
Very close. Mickey trying to make some big plays on the map right now. He's doing just fine in this laning phase so far, not falling behind in terms of CS. And we haven't seen that much pressure yet from Sazen. They finally have some wards around that mid lane so that he can play more aggressively, but got to make something happen here.
Yeah, wave clear, use by Sol, and he's just going to back off. Looks like they spotted Lyra coming into the jungle anyway. So Sol going to find an opportunity to go back here. Yep, just replacing that ward. That is about that.
Exciting times.
I know, right? I thought it was going to be a bit more aggressive than this. Oh, well. We've got plenty of games left for that to happen. Oh, Lyra coming in. They're going to try to make a play onto Sazen here. Pushes him back. Are they going to get the slough in time? Sazen uses that summoner heal, flashes over the wall, and it doesn't look like they can quite pursue him, and Mickey didn't quite get him low enough to hit him with the True Shot Barrage for the finisher.
Yeah, that's why you really need to make sure that you get these wards airtight around the mid lane, or you have your jungler there with you while you're pushing forward, because otherwise you leave yourself open to these ganks. Now he doesn't have any summoners. He's going to be even more reluctant to start chipping away at this turret, and there's nothing stopping Mickey's Rune-Glaive Ezreal from getting where he needs to be in this game.
Yeah,
be very strong at this stage, unless something drastic happens. They haven't been able to get the necessary, they haven't been able to starve him out, really, and they haven't been able to open up the map either. So Ketch right here, pretty much just been farming this game, and he's only 2 CS behind. He hasn't even really tried to make a play when it comes to ganking.
Yeah, it is a bit odd, actually, with especially because Rek'Sai has pretty decent wave clear to begin with, so kind of wonder what he's been doing a little bit.
Well, he's been farming, but not very efficiently.
Yeah, you'd think he'd be farther ahead.
Lyra has at least been putting pressure down. He's been seen on wards in the top side, forced Sol to play very far back, got the first blood. Just nothing else happening right now. Now he blew two summoners, and Ketch has to do something here. He gets seen on another deep ward in his jungle. They've had, Anarchy's had good vision and good warding this whole game.
Whoa, uh-oh. That's some damage onto Secret. Could be in trouble. Drops the Tibbers with the stun, and Nuclear pulls him out just in time. Well, that was a nice try from Anarchy, but quick reaction from Secret and Nuclear, and they keep their support alive.
Yeah, good True Shot Barrage. Does actually force a summoner another lane, which is a big win. I don't think they had to use the Braum ultimate right there because they would have forced the Fate's Call either way, with or without using it. And since that spell is so quick, unlikely you're going to be able to hit the Annie. But
yeah.
In any case, they trade one ult for two and a summoner, so that's a good lead.
Oh, Sazen getting very low, and one last Mystic shot will get Mickey the kill. Well, what can you say? Just got a little bit too close, and the roam from Snowflower helped Mickey and Lyra pick that one up.
And you have to know that's coming. This is how Snowflower plays the game. They know that they chunked the Annie out, but Secret had to go back to base. That opens up an opportunity for Snowflower to the mid lane, and here's the true shot.
Nope. Nice dodge. Unlikely that he would have hit him. I mean, with the tunnels, it's easy for Ketch to dodge that one, but either way, good thing to try if you're Mickey anyway.
And right there, I mean, what do you say? You know that Snowflower's been opened up for the roam. You know that Snowflower likes to camp the mid lane with Lyra. Can't be making those kind of mistakes. So now Sazen's Victor starting to fall behind, and it's going to be very tough to contain this Rune-Glaive Ezreal. He has been getting all the blue buffs. They haven't been threatening the blue buff at all. Despite having the Kalista, they should have pressure on this lane with Annie Kalista. And Ketch has yet to make a gank.
I'm pretty shocked to begin with that they gave Mickey this Rune-Glaive Ezreal.
But he lost with it last time he played it.
Still though, I mean, it's just such a strong champion. I feel like you can't be like, oh, well, he lost one game with it, you know, so.
Well, I think that if we look at the way that Anarchy wins games, it's not when Mickey is hanging it back and poking, typically. It's when he is in the mix in the back line. That is how they win. And in this particular circumstance, this has not been an effective style of League of Legends for Anarchy. So I don't think it's a problem to give him the Rune-Glaive Ezreal. I think it's a big problem the way that Spenu has done nothing to slow it down. They haven't even tried.
Well, here comes Lyra now clearing out even more wards. So Sazen just keeps getting pushed back.
And what this means is now there's amazing pressure on Secret to lock down the Ezreal.
Oh, Tibbers used. Snowflower gets stunned. They're going to try to get ahead. Secret flash for that for the Ignite, but it's nowhere near enough damage. Summoner heal used for Song Yun, and That's going to keep Snowflower alive. So another attempt to take out a support in the game, and it does not work out.
Really doesn't. I was curious if we'd actually see some more, basically a movement to the Runin's Hurricane here from the Kalista as a first item, which isn't something we've seen in Korea. Hmm. But because of that nerf to her basic attack damage, getting a bunch of spears ready for her rend may actually be the more efficient way to itemize her. So
I'm, could be.
You're probably going to see it as a second item, just wanting that sustain, I guess, right now. And with the Q max first, of course, you're still going to scale off of that BF sword. So it's not bad. I'm just curious how this changes the thought process, if at all. Lyra is deep right here. There is a rumble right there. And
he's been on some dangerous missions this game, but so far has not really been punished for it. Going for the blue buff now. Nope, back over the wall.
Yep.
So now, Spenu was able to use that aggression in bot lane to take the dragon, so at least they did get something out of it, aside from a summoner or two.
All right, catches here, and Secret coming up right now. No flash for Secret. So it will be very difficult for him to do anything about Mickey pushing forward here and spamming those Qs and Ws into Sassen. But Mickey now completely in control of this lane, has the Runeglaive, got his needlessly large rod, so very dangerous situation for Spenu. They're a couple K behind right now. The only advantage that they have is they have that one dragon.
Yeah, pretty much. With that rumble, you'd think they could keep fighting dragon a bit anyway.
Oh yeah, they can.
They've got a strong team fight with this team.
Yeah, but late game, I mean, it's going to be very, very difficult for them to do anything about this Ezreal. They decided to pick the Annie instead of the Braum. They wanted that engage. They thought this was going to be enough. They didn't take the Maokai. They took the Rumble instead. But that meant that they had to stall this out. They had to just deal with Mickey in the mid lane before it got too crazy. And 16 minutes into this one, and a kill advantage already to Anarchy. Spenu has to do something drastic.
Well, I wonder how Secret's Braum is, because he's been good on, you know, Alsar, Janna, but he doesn't really seem to have the biggest champion pool. So I wonder how much of that choosing to not take Braum was just because he simply can't play it very well.
I don't know. Braum is not that hard of a champion to use mechanically.
Really.
So you're pretty much just watching out for a true shot barrage and hitting your unbreakable and jumping to somebody. So I don't know how much that of a factor that is.
Oh, Lyra, right. Mikey caught here, throws down the ward. No reaction. Can't quite catch him.
Not enough people there to effectively follow up on that. That plan is just abandoned.
Yeah, pretty much. Nuclear looking to hit his level 10 here fairly soon. Not a fairly passive game yet overall, aside from a couple kills coming in from Anarchy. A nice taking of the dragon by Spenu.
Well, not sure what this Kalista pick is supposed to do in this particular game. Not looking like it's going to be really taking over the lane. They didn't get any ganks for their Annie-Kalista combo. Lyra has really been, I think, the star of this game so far. He's made it work, and there we go.
Oh, yep, they find Lyra. He's right there. Nice slash from Nuclear. Oh, he gets pushed back anyway, though. Snowflower coming in, misses his ult. Secret drops the Timbers to slow down Songyun and Lyra, and it looks like they have to back away. Secret gets a bit low, but he does save his AD carry. Oh, here comes True Shot Barrage, though. Look out, Secret. Whoa, that was close.
Still takes a nice chunk out of Nuclear. He'll be able to heal that up very quickly
with
the help of the Bloodthirster, but that's the Anarchy with another attempt at some aggression. And they get another summoner spell, another two summoner spells, as a matter of fact, for it. They don't use anything of their own. So Spenu has just been pretty comprehensively outplayed player by player. And catch, again, has been a total non-factor.
Yeah. I got my hopes up. I got my hopes up too high. I mean, we're only 18 minutes into the first game, but it's not looking good, is it?
Yeah, it's not. I think Lyra really is outclassing Catch here. And
you know, the thing is, too, is that I feel like if Spenu doesn't win a match today, that's kind of it. I feel like this is their last best chance to win a match this season.
Probably. It's hard to argue with that.
We've never had a completely defeated. I guess the opposite of undefeated is defeated. So we've never had a winless match or winless team in Champions before.
To be fair, this is the first year that we've actually started running the league format.
True.
So it's we've only had, this is only the second season.
It's not a large sample size. Hard to imagine, man. Oh, and Secret could be in a lot of trouble. That's a big True Shot Barrage. Wow, Mickey just destroys him. Oh, man. Well, that's a lot of damage coming in, and he is certainly a bit vulnerable.
Certainly is. He is now up 25 CS. No threat to his turret. Already has Lulud Zeko 2 kills. We said, who carries these teams? It's Mickey and Sasan. Now Sasan is heavily losing this lane, and there is not much that he can do.
Yeah, it's going to need
Mickey
to be.
Mickey going to start slash laughing in the mid lane.
It's going to need to be like a miracle team fight for Spender to have any hope this game. Otherwise, you may actually see this one get closed out pretty quickly.
So with the destruction of the tower in the bottom lane, that will mean that Songyun is now up at the top side. Still only 25 seconds to go on this dragon. So lane assignment may be a bit of
a trying to make a play on the Mickey, and there's the Tippers. They're going to catch him, but will there be enough damage? Mickey gets taken out. Sasan drops the Chaos Storm on him, and that is a big kill to get right before dragon comes. And if Spenu can get the second dragon, that may give them a little bit of a new lease on life.
And that is pretty much the only way they can kill Mickey. Yes. However, when you make a play like that, it is going to always take Sasan's flash if Mickey is positioned properly to get in range to burst him down. So Spenu still has a tiny amount of hope.
Yeah.
They're going to trade a dragon for a tier one tower in top lane. They get a kill on a Mickey, slow him down just a little bit. But the other issue with this is Mickey, once he gets a QSS, that is no longer going to be possible, and there is no other way to catch him.
Pretty much. Pretty much. Unless he happens to arcane shift right on top of the equalizer or something and then gets slowed. Trying to imagine ways.
Forever the optimist.
Not a lot of them.
There's not.
Hey, I'd just like to explore all the options.
It is still going to be difficult. He can even have a Banshee, so he doesn't even have to get a QSS.
I mean, Sasan, the core item behind him. And it doesn't look like he's going to be able to build in anything anytime soon.
No, there are a lot of issues. So, here we go, more harassment.
Oh, what? Stun comes in and Mickey gets a bit too close, and that's another kill for Sasan. They're really taking advantage of the no flash for Mickey, and they just need to keep doing that, man. If they can keep making those plays until that flash is up again, Mickey could be in a little bit of jeopardy.
Mickey also arcane shifted into Sasan right there.
Hey.
He did not know where Secret was on the map, so that actually made it very easy to set that up. So he already used his mistake, or his escape, in a foolish fashion.
When are you going to stop making excuses for Mickey, Monte Cristo? They just caught him twice.
First one was good. The second one was definitely Mickey's fault.
So you're saying there's a chance.
Well, if you keep arcane shifting into your opponent, if you want to be like Woong, then yes. Yes,
see,
there is a chance.
I thought he would arcane shift onto like an equalizer. I didn't realize he'd arcane shift right into Annie's stun.
Well,
that's even better.
Secret had to flash for it.
Yeah.
But still, pretty sloppy.
Still. They may be able to get a bot turret from this too. Songyun's going to start coming down, but I don't think he can get there in time. Just a little bit too dangerous, so to take that one out. Yeah. Not really a lot of wards in river, so they don't know if people are coming right down. Well, things are still looking pretty good for Anarchy, but that they've at least gotten a little bit interesting anyway. Monte Cristo doesn't look very interested, though.
I'm not. I'm really not very interested in Runeglaive Ezreal as a concept. Can't wait till that goes away in delightful patch 5.14.
What about Runeglaive Ziggs?
No. No more Runeglaive.
Oh.
I'm over it already.
It's
I thought I liked
gone.
It, but then I got bored with it.
This season has been kind of like the season of jungle items that have a big effect in other lanes and then get nerfed into oblivion.
They're escaping the jungle, Doa.
That's right. Season 5 has truly been a rumble in the jungle.
No, it's more like a rumble with the jungle items.
Rumble outside of the jungle.
There actually hasn't been much rumbling in the jungle. In fact, since the debut of Cinderhulk, there has been less rumbling in the jungle than there has been ever since ever before.
There was never a lot of rumble in the jungle to begin with.
Oh, come on. You could definitely like see Kha'Zix and Lee Sin duels going, people going at it.
Oh, I thought you meant the actual champion. Oh, they catch Songyun, and that's going to be another kill for Nuclear, but here comes the teleport. Ixu all over Nuclear right away. Sol there to protect him. Could drop a nice equalizer onto these guys. They're going to escape over the wall, though. And another pick for Spenu. Don't call it a comeback. Ooh, chunk taken out of a few members of Spenu, but it's not going to save the turret for Anarchy, and the gold lead is closing a little bit.
I mean, what else are we going to call it here, Doa? It's been a 4K gold lead that has just basically melted away.
Yeah, down to 1K now.
In the last few minutes, and all of it's been based around Secrets Annie. He's been the one locking people down, making sure they get back into... Get back a couple of kills, and it's actually a shiv onto Nuclear.
Huh, okay. Interesting. Huh. It's not going to be a lot of damage, but I mean, it is more pushing power, I suppose.
Yeah, it is that wave clear.
Yeah.
So you can keep on pushing up some of these lanes. Obviously, Kalista's still a very good champion, even with those nerfs, but...
And it is attack speed as well, too, which is, you know, decent on Kalista.
Sure, but when you have the big-time rend with all of the extra targets that Hurricane gives you, that's what I thought would be more of a priority. Mm. But Korea's never liked that, and I guess they still don't.
Nope. Well, Secret taking the opportunity to get a couple deep wards down. And yeah, the second round of this season, you know, even though they haven't won a lot of games, Secret has consistently been a decent playmaker for his team. And I really wonder, I mean, after the season, our big long off season between Worlds and then 2016, I wonder what sort of changes we're going to see happen with Spenu.
Well, it'll be an interesting question. Obviously, they'll probably be doing a lot of scouting in solo queue during that period.
New jungler, new top laner. This team could maybe be something with a bit of practice.
I mean, they do actually have a substitute top laner. The only position that Spenu has that they don't have a substitute in is the jungle.
Yeah.
They have plenty of depth to this roster to work with.
You know, as kind of weak as Sol has looked too, I do feel like he's been better in the games we've seen Sor play.
This is true, but Sor gets you free Riven Bands, which is a nice bonus.
That is true, yeah. Well. Dragon coming up right now, and Spenu has all the vision here, and they catch Ixu. Wow, there's a knock of Ixu, goes back in onto Secret, but there's enough damage. He flashes over the wall. They use the Rend. There's the Equalizer getting very, very low, and they're going to go for a team fight. Big Tibbers. Lyra comes back to try to make a play here. Braumelt goes through, doesn't really do a whole lot. There goes Lyra. Ixu barely escaped, but they're just going to turn on this dragon. That's going to be dragon number three for Spenu.
Well, Spenu is doing a good job of creating picks and turning them into objectives, and so... They're going to get their third dragon pretty early in this one, about 27 minutes. So we only have to wait until about 39 minutes, until we get this fifth dragon stack on the line. If Spenu can secure the next one, too. And Anarchy just having trouble not getting picked off and eating a bunch of damage.
This has been Anarchy's season, though. I mean, their team has looked so aimless post, like, 20 minutes in the second round that... It isn't maybe too surprising that this is happening.
Yeah, and the real person who pays for this is, of course, Lyra.
Yeah.
Gets knocked up right here. But that Flame Spitter just doing so much damage to the front line. Great gravity field, too. Able to lock up Lyra. They nearly take down three. Anarchy very lucky they didn't actually lose more.
Good equalizer from Sol as well, too, right through the choke. It wasn't exactly the hardest to put down, but it did work.
Well, Secret has pretty much single-handedly gotten his team back in this game.
Yes, he has. Oh, careful. Dodging two-shot barrage, Chaos Storm, and there we go. Sossin flashing for the 1v1 onto Mickey. Oh, boy. It's time. It's Spenu's day.
Well, Mickey has been playing this Runeglaive Ezreal. He looks like he's so desperate to carry this team.
Yeah, he's trying.
And you have to be patient. You have to poke. He can't keep arcane shifting into the enemy. He's wooning right now.
he's wooning hard, it's true.
You can't woong.
Yeah. For the uninitiated, the woong is when you arcane shift into certain depth. over and over and over again. Usually found in the bot lane, but occasionally in the mid lane.
You never want to make the Woom decision. That's
right. Yeah.
Comes back to haunt you.
Well, it's okay, because as we learned in the past, time heals all wounds.
It does.
Yeah. Yep. See Arcane shifting forward already. Gotta be careful.
Well, I think he might be okay in his base.
You never know.
You never know. I mean, he's probably paranoid about this Annie these days.
Yeah.
Never know where that Annie's just gonna pop out of
a
bush and timbers you.
Secret's so bloodthirsty, dude. It's great. Making the plays, and they're gonna push up this lane again. And looks like they may try to collapse here too, although Sossin's not there. Soul is not there, although they do have the teleport. And Anarchy trying to put a little bit of pressure on the Baron area. Oh, can you smite it? Oh, no, didn't get it. They tried.
You know, the Baron area is actually just called a barony.
The barony?
Yeah.
Is that what, that's what we should call from now on?
Well, I mean, that's the technical barony? That's the technical term for a baron's land.
Yeah, we should use that. Sure, why not? The barony.
Just like that's where the word county comes from. Because that was
the count's land.
The count's land. That was the area controlled by a count.
What do you know? Saying there were counts in the U.S. at one point?
Yeah, I don't. I think it's just a word that they applied at that point. But
I don't remember
that's,
those.
That's where the root of the word comes from.
I want to be a count. If I ever move back there, I'll become the count.
Von Doa.
That's right, Count Von Doa.
That's a nice
ring. That'd be like of Doa, though. That wouldn't make any sense.
Well, you just name your county Doa.
That's true.
You'd be Doa Von Doa.
Welcome to Doa County, home of Doa Castle. You know, make it like a big tourist attraction, like the House on the Rock in Wisconsin, you know?
No, Doa. I don't know what Midwest tourist traps there are.
Like the world's largest ball of twine in Minnesota? Like the giant trout in Madison, Minnesota? Or was it a bass? I always forget.
So you don't even know the Midwest tourist traps.
Giant ear of corn somewhere nearby. There's a lot of giant plastic things. That's really small town Minnesota's claims of fame. Let's take something that pretty common. We'll make it big.
Just
make it big and call it the biggest in the world. Then people will flock from miles around to see it and buy taquitos from our gas stations.
How are
brilliant.
How are the Minnesota gas station taquitos?
Not good. not a good choice, I'm afraid. Better than the Slim Jim, anyway. Well, there goes that sponsorship, I suppose. Oh, well.
Gas station taquitos.
I cannot tell a lie.
We were actually in negotiations with gas station taquitos to sponsor OGN, and now you ruined it forever.
I can't just be like, snap into a Slim Jim and like get it back or something. Uh-oh, Mickey could be in a little bit of trouble. That's a lot of damage yet again. Nuclear tries to make a play, backs off at the last second. Oh, here comes Ixu. Nuclear getting very, very low. Got to be careful here. It's a brawl, and there's a kill. They take out Songyun. Snowflower barely alive. Sossin harassing the back lines, but he's okay. There goes Ixu, another one team fight for Spenu. Well, how about that?
That was a 5v4 because Lyra wasn't even there.
They snapped into a Songyun.
They certainly did.
Now it's time for Baron. I mean, this is how it's been, is catch people, win a team fight, take an objective.
Yeah, it's been very simple.
It's a good way to play League of Legends, isn't it?
It is a good way to play League of Legends, but it's also a very bad way to play League of Legends if you're Anarchy, because they've had some really big moments of over-aggression, especially from Mickey.
Oh, that Trish up Raj. Well, pretty close.
No, you're never going to outsmite a Rend stack from Nuclear.
Yeah.
Not really a thing that's going to happen.
I won't even contest that type nullifying.
So let's take a look at this again. I mean, Soul is here. This starts as a 4v3 to start out with. Where is
Nuclear?
Lyra is just not even there right now. So Nuclear actually just gets Twisted Advance up right out of the teleport. Lyra comes, but by the time he's there, so is...
Sossin just zones him out.
Secret in the back. And, yeah, really not even willing to commit to that. Probably should have at least used his explosive cast to try and disengage for a few members of his team.
I would think so. So Dragon is up again. Baron-powered Spenu is coming back to try to do something about it. They did get the Speed Shrine from the Rift Scuttler. So Anarchy, Spenu can probably still just fight this. But do you take that risk? Do you just say, hey, go ahead and take that dragon. We're just going to push lanes. I feel like you don't need to fight this dragon too hard.
Well,
what do you think? Looks like they're going to just get it anyway.
I think you might consider this just a little bit, because otherwise you're going to spend the rest of the game staring down the five dragon stacks. But with that Baron buff, there's not a really good way. Nope, not going to work. So,
wow.
Early True Shot Barrage, and Spenu on the cusp of going 1-0 in this series.
Yeah. Well, I'm still saying 2-1 overall. And we saw how Anarchy did have a pretty substantial lead in the early game. It was just picks largely created by Secret that have led back to this pretty dominating second half of the game for Spenu.
Well, they just had to be careful. And, you know, honestly, Mickey is just not very good at playing this Runeglaive Ezreal. He likes to go all in. And you just can't do that with this Ezreal pick. Sossin is playing Victor. He has more burst. He will just destroy you. He has a summoner heal. You don't. If you try and 1v1 this guy and you try and get your arcane shift damage in, it's over.
Yeah.
You're dead. So Mickey playing vastly too aggressive. You have to be patient. Where is the power of Runeglaive Ezreal? It's in his patience and his poke. And you just need to stand back and do the work over time instead of trying to be the hero.
That's going to be another turret going down in favor of Spenu. I mean, here's the question now then. So if Mickey can't handle this Runeglaive Ezreal, do you have to ban it next game or risk giving it to Sossin? Because we know Sossin can play it really well.
Very good on it, yes.
Yeah.
That is true. So yes, I do think that they will just ban it out, because it's obvious that they consider it a priority. They did first pick it on the red side. We could expect Spenu to do the exact same thing.
Absolutely. Oh, that turret nearly going down as well.
Again, we could see Anarchy try and play the Yasuo game. Say, we've got this Yasuo. They picked Yasuo after SK Telecom picked the Ezreal in their last meeting. But in the end, Faker ended up just playing Aurelia against the Yasuo and doing very well in that lane.
Spenu just kind of dotting the I's and crossing the T's on this one, just keeping the lanes pushed up. And they don't really need to be aggressive at all right now. They can just wait until that fifth dragon.
Yeah, they're going to get it in 3 minutes. And there's not very much. They're going to force an apocalyptic fight with Anarchy at that dragon. It doesn't even really matter if they get it or not, because they still have that late game fifth dragon to think about. They can just keep threatening that objective, considering that Anarchy has zero.
Yep. I gotta say too, Nuclear's Kalista has been very good. The way he played in that last team fight before they got Baron as well was pretty impressive. Playing just barely on the edges of danger.
He got caught out a little bit early. He was standing next to the minion that there was a TP on, so he did eat the immediate Twisted Advance and have to use a summoner. But other than that, it's been pretty nice.
Yeah. Better than what we've seen from Songyun, at least.
Oh, yeah, that's true. I mean,
yeah.
Songyun has just not delivered on the Kalista at all.
It's interesting to think, too, that, like, right now, Spenu is stronger on these major power picks than Anarchy is, and it looks like they may have caught Lyra again a little bit. A little bit of damage onto him. But yeah, I mean, Anarchy, they can't play the Runeglaive Ezreal. They can't really play the Kalista. Those are some pretty important champions to be able to play right now.
Well, it's just not their meta. They were thriving earlier when they actually got these assassin picks.
Oh,
here we
teleport
go.
Teleport coming in. Did they catch Catch? We'll see. He burrows under the wall. Ixu trying to come in with that home guard, but they've still got that teleport defending them. And Spenu is going to be just fine. So there's the teleport burn. Sol used it as well, though. And Anarchy just going for it, man. You got to try something.
Yo, Void Rush coming back
through. Are they going to go in here? Perhaps, if they can catch Mickey, he's poking from the outside for now.
Well, at least Mickey has his flash up, so he can.
Yeah.
He's not going to be as worried about dealing with this Annie.
Well, so. Baron and Dragon coming up within about 20 seconds of each other right now, which could make things a bit interesting. But Spenu obviously probably want to prioritize that fifth Dragon. Shot Barrage barely hits Seoul. That's not the way you want to use that. And are they going to come in? Seeker comes over the wall. There's a huge Timbers that goes down. Equalizer used. Doesn't do a whole lot. There's a kill already for Rumble. They're just going to go right in. Sangyun, Snowflower pushed away. And they can jump all over Iksu. Man, they blew up Mickey instantly. A double kill for Nuclear. And that has got to be near the end of the game. They're going to get an inhibitor and then just back off, take all the objectives they want. And they may be able to just send it right here, although without a minion wave, I don't know.
They're going to be waiting just a little bit for this one, but I think they may have the game.
They've got enough time. Yeah, I think they might.
I think they might too. If not, we'll find out very shortly. There's still an AD carry up, so they have to be careful.
He doesn't have his ultimate though, so that's a big part of this here. Already at about half health. There goes one turret. This one's going to be really close. I think Mickey up in 15 seconds. Sangyun very low though. Catch tried to flash for the kill, and now they're going in the Nexus. Looks like that is going to be it. Spenu with a nice comeback takes game one.
Well, and really big props to Spenu. When we were talking about that game, once Mickey started getting ahead, there was basically only one thing that they could do, Spenu, which is continually make the plays with the Annie stun into the Victor Burst. And that's hard to do against a champion like Ezreal. But you know what? Secret and Sasan really made it work.
Yeah.
And they consistently got Mickey down in those team fights by using the Flash Timbers and then a Flash Chaos Storm right on top of him. So very nicely done, actually, for Spenu. I didn't think that's a high execution.
I wonder what Anarchy's got in mind here as we go into picks and bans for game number two.
They will be banning Ezreal.
Gotta ban Ezreal. Oh, yeah.
That is what I think. As for Spenu, who took out Zed, Ahri, and TF in that first game, they're not going to have quite so many bans available to them in this game.
Right. Well, Rek'Sai and Zed, the first two bans, and there's a Gragas as well.
Interesting. I wonder what Anarchy wants to first pick here, because they could ban Annie and try and first pick Alistar and put Secret on something a little bit more uncomfortable. Meanwhile, Spenu gonna keep up with the... Wow, so either Ryze or Kalista is likely going through right now. But again, Sangyun, you're not really worried about him having Kalista.
Yeah, so you have to still ban the Ryze.
You do have to be a little bit more worried about Iksu having Ryze.
Yeah. You do have to ban the Ryze over the Kalista, definitely against Anarchy, I think. And will they ban that Ezreal? No, Kalista ban, wow.
So looks like more than likely it will be a Ryze ban here.
Yep,
and so the Twisted Fate is left up, but they have a counter pick, remember. So Spenu, they don't have to be as worried about Twisted Fate when they have an opportunity to get a counter pick, as opposed to Zed and Ahri, those champions that Mickey could really, really go off on.
Yeah, and you're going to be giving Secret either Alistar or Annie here too, so it's tough, man. They're going to grab the Thresh for Snowflower. He is a great Thresh player, but
not sure that is a
priority
pick.
Is it first pick worthy? Yeah,
I'm sure that is a priority pick here. We have a lot still on the board. Obviously, the Alistar, the Maokai. These are all the Victor possible champions, the Kog'Maw that we might see first pick these days.
Well, I think Kog'Maw would be a good takeaway. And I like the Eve, too, when you know the Rek'Sai is not available for the other team.
I agree. Makes things a lot more difficult for Lyra. They banned two junglers. So what is Lyra going to play here?
Probably, I don't know, Jarvan.
Echo.
No, probably Echo.
Yeah, Echo. Probably Echo. Nidalee, still options.
Yeah. Have we seen Lyra play Nidalee yet this season? I don't remember. I don't think we have. He's played plenty of Echo. I'd love to see some Swain, but I don't think we're going to see that. Sorry, DeFizio.
Is he a Swain fan?
I believe so. All right, Rumble Eve.
Okay, so going with the early Rumble pick, of course, with the changes to the itemization, that is a very nice early pick to grab these days. Lyra could go back onto something like the Lee Sin in this particular instance, and he has played Lee this season.
Yeah, Lee Sin would make sense, but I think the Echo would be a little bit more in line with what he's been playing lately. But, you know, if he thinks there's going to be that mid Ezreal for Sasan, perhaps, wants to try to, well, it's hard to land a Dragon's Rage on an Ezreal.
I
don't know.
He lost one of his games on Nidalee. I remember him losing one game on Nidalee, and that
I
is
see.
True.
I see. Wow, Hecarim.
Bold.
Yeah, not a champion we see a lot. I mean, I think this mid Ezreal is starting to look better and better, honestly. I mean, you can avoid Thresh. Lee Sin's not a big threat against Ezreal. Hecarim is not a big threat.
Well, if you can get that home guard flank and you have the items, he will be a threat against the mid lane Ezreal because you can do some damage in that back line.
You're saying he comes in so fast, it's hard to get out of the way.
Yeah, and you can, even if you are Arcane Shift, he'll just ult you right afterwards.
Seems like it's still going to be the Corki Ezreal, though, for Spenu. Wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, you have to think this is going to be Rumble Corki Ez. It's a very standard composition right now. Huge amounts of poke damage with Equalizer and then the Rockets and the True Shot Barrage.
They can wait to take the LSR, or they can take it right now. I mean, it seems to stand to reason that it's not going to be taken by Anarchy after last game, so.
Yeah, I'd take the Alistar. That gives you a bit more of a front line when you have that Rumble. So you have somebody very, very tanky to absorb some of that damage for your poke.
True.
So with the Corki taken, now we get to see what exactly is the mid lane going to be. Are they going to blind pick the TF? This would be fine into the Ezreal too. Yeah, same philosophy. You can push forward.
Wow, Jinx though. I'm a little bit surprised about that. Jinx is very vulnerable, to say the least.
Less vulnerable when they pick the TF at the same time, because of course TF is a very good counter pick to Jinx, because she just sits in the back line, and if you get in there and gold card her, you're not going to have too many issues.
Wow,
but they're going to go for the Victor again. Sasa did have a good Victor game, so no Runeglaive Ez this time around.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised we're not going to see that. I guess Victor's a little bit safer in lane against the TF, and that's probably the primary concern, is they just don't want to feed Mickey, you know?
Well, what's going to happen here is that Mickey, what he wants to do is push out the lane and then try and get those ults off, of course.
Yeah,
and
true,
if you can't match his wave clear, which the Ezreal can't match early, Mickey may have some very influential first couple of teleports. And in that situation, he may be trying to feed the Hecarim in the top side, getting Hecarim that Trinity Force, and that's going to be a major factor in this game. So we have to watch the top side very closely here. Soul gave up that early kill, fell behind in farm compared to Ixu in the last game. Catch has to do better about dealing with the Rumble in the top side, making sure that he's not caught out by this very powerful early game combo of TF and Lee Sin, and then handing Hecarim these kills with the Ignite. So it's all about playing around the top lane this game. Sasan has to keep on the pressure so that Mickey cannot leave the lane.
Yeah, this is going to be a big test for Catch, and traditionally that has not been the greatest thing for Spenu. So Rebels Anarchy may have put something together that'll help them tie up the series. We will see, though. Spenu on the verge of potentially winning their first match of the entire season. Can they get the 2-0, or will Anarchy tie things up? Let's get in the game and find out. I almost said, will Annie tie things up? And I'm like, yeah, well, it's possible, but just not in this game. Here we go, Rebels Anarchy versus Spenu.
Are they going to Sonic Boom their way to their first best of three victory?
Well, you know, it was very much like a Sonic Boom last game. They kind of held back for a while, and then it was forward and punch really fast. Classic Sonic Boom.
Yeah, Mickey didn't know how to dodge it. Couldn't jump over it.
That's true,
Got hit by the Sonic Boom. That was it.
Yep. Don't want to get hit by that Sonic Boom. That could lead to all sorts of combos, which it did. Some sick combos coming out of Sonic Boom last game.
And that's why we didn't see Mickey at Evo.
There you go.
Just eats the Sonic Boom.
Yep. Well, Anarchy with some deep early wards here, but Spenu keeping an eye on things as well. What do you think? Are we going to see any lane swap in this game? Probably not. Doesn't look that way.
Nope. Should just see the standard lanes here. It's been a long time since we've seen a Jinx here in Champions. Never really, of course, that popular in Korea to begin with. Always a bit of a rare sight. The unicorn of AD carries. Actually, that's Ashe.
That's true. Ashe is truly the, well, or Quinn maybe, one of the two.
I don't know if we can call Quinn an AD carry.
More like the lake sturgeon that is hard to find, but you really just want to kind of get rid of, huh?
I don't call Quinn an AD carry. I just call her crap.
Oh, boy. Somewhere a single tear slides down Daniel Klein's face.
He didn't make Quinn.
Yeah, but still, he's involved in the champion design, people. I don't know the name of any of the champion designers. Sorry, guys.
I think Daniel Klein actually secretly hates the person who made Quinn.
Oh, really?
I think he's happy right now.
Oh, that's juicy, man. Put that on Reddit.
I don't even know.
Drama at Riot Games.
I don't even know who made Quinn.
Confirmed on OGN stream. Oh, actually, confirmed on Riot Games stream now. We'll just blame Daniel Klein. We can do that, right? Anytime we don't like a champion?
Yep.
Pretty sure.
Well, apparently, that's what you're doing, so.
Precedent has been set. Wow, Nuclear taking a lot early trading damage here. Snowflower taking a good amount himself as well. But the lane pressure is certainly going in Anarchy's favor for the moment anyway, and you'd expect it to. Ooh, close. Close to landing that death sentence onto Nuclear. If there's anything, though, that Nuclear is good at, it's not dying. Even when Spenu loses, he generally doesn't die a whole lot.
No, he doesn't. And he also has the sustain here, too. Of course, with the Relic Shield and the Cow Roaring.
Oh, Lyra coming up as well, too. Really putting the pressure on to catch. Here comes Secret, though.
Yeah.
All right, blue buff taken by Lyra.
Interesting pathing, just going from the red right in. They're trying to make use of Lee Sin's early game power here. And Snowflower, we've seen how confident he is in terms of his roaming.
Oh, boy.
This.
He's really good on this thresh. They don't see her because of the passive. Here comes Catch now, just going to smite it right away.
And now has that Wolf Spirit. Snowflower going to actually get
it. Nice grab on the catch. Yeah, Lyra coming in as well. Will they have enough damage? Q lands. They're not going to connect. And actually, Lyra, it almost looked like he flashed, but I guess he sort of just popped over the wall there.
So they've tried to be aggressive, not really that effective because we could see Catch already very close to being in between his tier 1 and tier 2 towers. Victor was there. And Nuclear and Secret playing pretty far back right now. Snowflower really hasn't lost all that much XP. He's going to be a level down off of the next minion, but so he lost about 50% of the level there. That's about it. And now can Secret and Nuclear kind of start to push back out here? The Jinx doing a good job of bullying with that range.
B, see the win rate a little bit higher for Secret's Alistar. And, you know, as long as the Spenu bot lane stays safe early on, as long as they stay even in CS, Nuclear can comfortably hit level 6, you know, then I feel like they can open things up quite a bit. You know, then we're going to see Secret going in and making those plays on the Alistar. Good start so far. You know, the funny thing is, despite all the pushing, Songyun is still down by 2 CS Nuclear, which is a bit shocking now that I look at that.
Well, yeah, we'll see once it pushes back out the lane and how that is going to shake out in the end. Probably it should even up. Oh, no, it won't. He actually is just going to be behind in terms of CS.
Wow.
Go back to the Krugs.
I'm really surprised by that. You would think, even with Corki, you know, doing pretty well under turret as far as farming goes, that Songyun would have a little bit more CS at this point.
Yeah, he did have to play back a little bit while Snowflower was in the enemy jungle roaming, so perhaps he just wasn't going for some of the riskier CS, didn't want to be all in.
Oh, tried to get the Pulverize onto Snowflower, but didn't quite land it, and that means no catch for catch.
No catch for catch. Well, this mid lane is going quite well for Sasin so far. He's starting to build up a nice little lead.
Yeah.
Zoning the TF out, of course, with that low mobility, you may have some issues. Sasin has gone for the cleanse this game to deal with the gold cards.
Yeah, and we can see Sol putting down some deeper wards this time around, not playing it quite so crazy up in top lane. Still going to need catch up there once TF hits 6. But he's a little bit better situated to avoid Lyra anyway.
Very interesting composition from Anarchy because they have a lot of very useful tools to deal with Sasin. They've got, of course, the displacement from the Lee Sin kick. They have a lot of backline threat on Victor with the Hecarim and the Twisted Fate. So if they can kill him quickly, that may lead to a nice follow-up from Songyun where he can get a lot of resets. It's definitely a very reasonable composition to run against Victor due to the fact that he has no natural escapes. He's just going to have to try and zone as best he can with the gravity field. And there's not a lot of good peel. Secret's mostly going to be wanting to deal with the front line. So Victor and Corki are sort of all on their own back there. And that may lead to some good Anarchy plays onto the carries. There's not very much between them and getting onto Sasin's Victor.
Well, Lyra comes in and takes the Gromp. They're going to see him, though. So they do know what's up there. And Lyra hasn't been back in a long time, actually. interestingly enough. That's waiting for those wolves, I guess. Huh.
I think he, see what he's waiting for here.
Yeah, it's a bit, he could be waiting, maybe the blue buff?
Yeah, he could be waiting for the blue buff. It looks like he took his blue buff.
Yeah, no opportunities really for Dragon yet, although with the double recall for Spenu, maybe, nah, maybe.
All right, catch a scene right there, but it does pop his Raptor buff, so he's going to know exactly what's going on there.
Yep.
Really delayed blue taken by Lyra, actually. He waited a long time to take his own blue. And now he is, yeah, that's a bit curious. So if they don't get Mickey this blue buff at the enemy blue, they may be waiting for quite some time, because remember the early pathing of Lyra was his red to the enemy blue.
Yeah, Mickey's pretty low on mana anyway, and you know, of course you do have some sustain from that blue card, but yeah, he definitely needs to go back now and be ready in case a dragon fight breaks out here.
Wow, Warrior Enchant. Lee Sin. I love it. You're going to play Lee Sin.
Nice and aggressive. Oh, speaking of aggressive, Nuclear going in onto Songyun there, taking some decent damage. Here comes TF, Secret, a little bit of trouble. Nuclear, will he get gold carded as Ixu comes out, knocks Nuclear back in her turret. Ixu has to ult away, but that's going to be first blood going to Mikyu. Oh, big true shot. Oh, big, not true shot, Equalizer going down, but it splits up the team of Anarchy. Doesn't catch anybody, though.
That was such a huge investment from Anarchy. Sure, they get the kill. Mickey has that Sheen. He's got the burst. He manages to take out Nuclear, but it came at a pretty high price.
So many people got really low there. You know, can Spenu just take Dragon in response?
No, they can't.
I guess
really.
They didn't go back. Okay.
I mean, Nuclear's going to be back with a buy, and Songyun has that BF sword already. We'll see. There are a lot of recalls coming in now, a little bit delayed as they had to push the wave off of the turret. So Anarchy just going for another invade here. Onto the Gromp, and it looks like they know, Spenu knows exactly what's going on in their own jungle right now.
Bit of an odd situation with that fight. And Nuclear a little bit down on CS. They're going to need to do a lot more than kill him once. But either way, getting a kill onto that Twisted Fate with the very first ultimate is exactly what you want to do if you're Anarchy.
It could have gone better. It is true that it wasn't a perfect gank right there. They did get low. They only got the one kill.
Yeah.
And it was disengaged relatively well by Spenu, and it required a massive investment into a tower dive.
I mean, they didn't lose Dragon for it, though. They only lost one person. Could have been a lot worse for Anarchy.
Certainly could have. So, Dragon still available for the taking, and now zero global pressure for the time being from Anarchy, so Spenu has a chance just to farm it out right here.
Ooh, Ixu very low, and no flash because he didn't take the summoner, just trying to get away with that E, and he'll barely make it out.
Dropped the Equalizer.
I was going to say, I feel like Equalizer could have really been
Ixu
helpful
didn't
there.
Didn't even have his ult.
Yeah, I have no idea why he didn't do that.
His ult, he was dead.
He's not a very good top laner. All right, going in, onto Snowflower. There's a knock-up. Lyra throws in the Q, but they're just going to chase. There's a flash from Snowflower.
Plowing that snow.
I guess so.
He's got his snow truck.
Really have been.
He's going to clear out the streets of Seoul.
It's a very Minnesota-oriented cast tonight, apparently.
There's plenty of snow in Seoul for the Snowflower here.
Not these last couple of years, though.
There's been enough. They've had to break out the plows.
Have they?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
You have to plow the streets.
Dude,
when it
in
snows.
My neighborhood, there was like no snow at all this last winter.
No snow at all.
More or less.
No, it can't be more or less than no snow at all.
Mostly no snow.
Sorry, you don't get
almost
a,
no.
You
snow.
Don't get to sit here and make absolute statements, and then that got them snow.
Sure, you do, man. That's how you use English now. You make lots of absolute statements and just expect people to assume that you mean the not absolute. Where have you been for the last 10 years?
Not doing that because it's ridiculous.
Well, get with the times, man.
No, I will not.
Time marches on, with or without you, Monte Cristo.
It's okay. I don't care. I march to the beat of my own drum, Doa.
We'll see what you say when we're all in our robot bodies communicating just fine and you won't understand a thing.
I'll be happily dead by that time.
That got dark really fast, didn't it?
No, I'd be happy. It's fine.
Oh, all right. Wow. Oh, Mickey could be in a little bit of trouble. Here comes Catch with the ultimate. Can they do something? Nope. Lantern will pull Mickey to safety through the dark passage.
Which is actually light because it's a lantern.
Through the light passage. Nope. Headbutt pulverize onto Lyra. There's a flash for him, though, so he could have used it if he didn't already have something that let him get over walls.
Is basically a flash without using flash?
Yeah. Exactly. Nerf, please. Still no dragons, so it's been a long game without dragons.
It has been. Well, I mean, it's not. It's only 12 minutes into this. There's actually been a lot of action in the lane so far.
Yeah.
Maybe seeming like a little bit later than it actually is. This time, I mean, it's pretty normal to see the first dragon go down at 14, 15 minutes in Korea.
I suppose.
So here we go.
They're going to try to make a play on the Soul. Flashes even as the gold card hits him under the turret. Ixu taking a lot of damage there. Good equalizer, but not quite enough. Catch a little bit too afraid to go in there with three members of Team Anarchy. So they are making good plays with this TF. And
that is the danger. I mean, I talked about this in the champ select.
Yep.
That Hecarim Lee Sin TF combo is very deadly to Soul's Rumble. Not really much counterplay to what was given unless you have Catch ready in the top side. And Sasan, again, I feel like, just like I felt last game, he's not punishing enough with this victory. He doesn't have the vision in the mid lane to actually play in a more aggressive fashion. I mean, even though Mickey went out of the lane right there, he didn't actually put that much damage down onto the turret itself.
Yeah.
So it's basically there was no counterplay whatsoever. And because Catch was on the top side, but he was too late, they couldn't actually do the dragon.
Oh, gold card used early. Oh, flashes over the headbutt. There's a summoner to use, but he got out of what would have been probably certain death.
Tricky. Tricky for Mickey.
Tricky Mickey. Although, not exactly a win for Anarchy there. Having to use that flash. Just an ability combo from Alistar.
Now, a lot of disrespectful plays from Mickey this game. He's taking some very high-risk, low-reward plays. Because realistically, even if he had been able to get onto Sasan, his cleanse was up. So he's probably not going to kill him, especially that close to the tower. Even though he does have the ignite.
That's the danger, is that you get a little bit ahead, and then you start to get a little bit too excited about it. And here's a dragon attempt. Coming in from Anarchy, will Spenu try to punish this? It doesn't look like they will, and first dragon of the game taken by Anarchy. They didn't get a single one in game number one.
Yeah, and how is Mickey after having,
there's a gank onto Sasan, but here comes Secret just gonna push Mickey right away. Sasan's still in a lot of trouble though. Nice pulverize, might have saved the mid laner. No, Lyra able to get that kill, nearly goes down to the turret, somehow makes it out, and it's a melee in the mid lane now. There goes Spirit, another kill for Mickey. And Anarchy takes a turret, takes a team fight. Somehow Lyra survives.
Lyra having a giggle right there. He actually lived through the ignite from Secret.
Yeah.
So an all-in on that mid lane, and there's just no response on the map from Spenu. Soul uses teleport right there, and here we go.
Well, gold card going to be going down. Nuclear already uses that Valkyrie. A lot of damage onto Mickey, but Songyun walking right in with all those auto attacks. That is going to be a dead Corki. There's the flay. And Songyun, the rest of Anarchy, definitely getting excited about that one.
And just a rocket, too.
Oh.
Hello.
Oh, look out.
So,
yay, celebration rocket.
I mean, if we look at this right now, the tower's already deeply chipped out, so they try and make a play. Snowflower misses the hook. Lyra gets the kick, doesn't quite finish off Sasan. And now they turn on to Lyra, but a flash will get the kill finally for Lyra. He escapes with just a tiny amount of health. But there's four people in the mid lane right now. And what is Corki doing? I mean, you shouldn't be able to stack like that for such... There's been no counterplay cross-map from Spenu this entire game. Basically, Anarchy just makes a play and Spenu sits there every single time.
Yeah, I mean, if you're Corki and the dragon's already down, there's really not a lot of reason for you to put tons of pressure on the bot lane like that.
Well,
you're not a great split pusher if you're Corki.
He has the Trinity Force, so he's definitely able to kill towers quickly.
Well,
that's what he had to do. He had to do something to respond to that, but he didn't pull back soon enough because obviously Anarchy could run from the mid to the bot lane, and you should know whether Destiny and Gate are up or not.
And where was Catch?
Yep. Well, it's been the story of the series, more or less.
Story of the season.
And Catch hasn't been there for any counter ganks. He hasn't been there for any ganks. He's ganked like what once this entire series so far?
Yeah.
Gank mid lane this game.
That's about it. And where there was a pretty big lead for Anarchy that they came back while Saucen gets grabbed by the death sentence, Flayed as well. Looks like he'll be able to make it up for now, but I mean, that was cute. But
the style W.
Yeah, I mean, even though we saw a lead of about this size last game and Spenu come back, this is a very different situation.
Well, they can still make picks. They absolutely can. They have an Evelynn. They can catch people off guard. They can then take the objectives off of it.
Anarchy, though, has much more pick pressure themselves this time around.
Yeah, it's hard. Uh-oh.
Oops. Uh-oh. Bug splat. Oh, no. Quick, W as fast as you can.
Oh, all right. Boy.
So what should we tell Riot about that bug splat? Well, we were observing the game, and Anarchy started winning, so
bug splat.
Yeah, so bug splat.
So we'll hope this wasn't one of the bug splats that will stop the loading at 80 or 90%.
Yep.
Oh, no, we're already back.
Yep, looks that way. All right, great. Whew, that was a close call, man. Gold card onto Soul, but not doing a whole lot.
I'm sure you guys all really enjoyed seeing the desktop of our observing PCs.
Yep. It was a beautiful thing. And so, as we and the players all regroup, looks like bottom turret's finally going to be taken by Spenu, or not. Or not. Big play going down the bot lane. Here comes Ixu. Flash used. Equalizer. They don't catch him with the Flay. Ah, but they do get Secret. Just ults right out of that one, though.
Yeah, no problem. But still, no objective able to be taken by Spenu. They're trying to get something. They want to claw their way back into some sort of gold relevance in this game.
Yeah. Wow, Snowflower just ate a big death ray.
Always hurts to eat the big death ray.
I know, right?
But I'm just really surprised That's about Saucen in this game, how he was falling so far behind Mickey's Twisted Fate, how even though Mickey was TPing in the other lanes, there was more damage onto Saucen's turret. Just really weird. I mean, you if you want to pick this victor, the best way to play around it is the way we see SKT do it. Play around it with a hell of a lot of wards so you can just continually win those trades and just grind down your opponent's tower over time.
Yeah. Well, Mickey chasing down Secret with that gold card, hovering ominously above his head. Wow, he tries to speed himself up, but doesn't quite get there. Huh. You know, it almost looks like Spenu is just nervous, you know? I mean, I wonder how much the pressure is, you know, being in a situation where they realistically could win their first series of the tournament.
Yep, and I mean, Spenu has had basically one good game a series, but they haven't ever actually put together two complete games.
True.
Here's the Destiny. Flash has to be used.
From Secret. Yeah, they tried to zone with the gravity field as well too. So
they knew his Unbreakable Will was down, so they basically get a free summoner, and now they have priority on this turret. And
Secret getting grab goes right in the middle. Wow, just immediately evaporates with all that damage. Snowflower manages to pick up the kill in the end, but when Alistar is dying like that, you know there's problems. Equalizer goes down, does split up Anarchy. He's just going to ult right back in. Ixu all over Catch, and the Ignite going to burn him down. Saucen turning around. Ixu still may be in trouble. There's Soul, comes right in with the auto attack for the kill, but now Jinx is getting excited. Songyun throws a rocket in there. Whoa, Lyra turns around for the kill onto Saucen, and that is nearly a clean ace, only losing Ixu. What a team fight. That's certainly going to be an inhibitor in favor of Anarchy.
Yeah, Anarchy just pushing this advantage forward. They're getting the resets for the Jinx here, which allows them to continue these fights. And they have so much CC from the Twisted Fate right now, just repeatedly taking those gold cards alongside the Thresh, that it's easy for them to follow up on some of these engagements and push through the turrets. They also have a Trinity Force, a Lich Bane, so they can go through the towers with some speed. Now Secret just makes a mistake right there in the front line when he knows his ultimate is down. And so another turret gets very, very low. It pops right there. That means Jinx gets excited. Ixu gets into the back line once again. Rocket going to run wide. And Ixu in a bit of trouble, but Soul just drills him right in the face. But Lyra, again, showing off his aggressively Sid plays, comes back, gets the kick onto Nuclear with a flash, really extending the play with the use of that Sonic Wave.
Yeah. It's been a bit of a bizarre game. You very seldom see games where Nuclear is 0-3-1. But this Corki has not been very good, and they just haven't played around the TF well as a team.
No, they do not understand how to play against TF. This is very strange to see, and it's been a very dominating, what I assume will be a win for Anarchy here. They're on the Baron. They have an 11K gold lead. They are on the cusp of taking this one home.
Yep, 10-1 in kills. And doesn't look like it's anything to do yet. Just burning the ult just to make sure they have vision over the team. Mickey, Megawin anyway. Nope. Just over to the other side of the jungle just to push up that bot lane. Or kill the wolves.
The wolves are mine. I used my ult for this.
Goodbye, wolves. I came for you. Well, Spinu trying to set up a pick here. Mickey's like, where is everybody? Suspicious. Whatever you say, Rumble. Oh, the grab misses Nuclear because he's going deep. There's some flashes used. Catch trying to make a play, but no play to be made. And Sossin still taking some serious damage on that Tier 2 turret. Oh, only Ixu dying so far on Anarchy. What a huge difference. Look at that, 42,000 to 29,000
yep.
at 23 minutes.
Very early in the game, too. So
yeah.
It's pretty much nothing that Spenu can do, especially because the magic resist building is going to be just immensely effective against them. Mm. So this gold going to be pretty darn efficient when it comes to itemizing defensively against what Spenu is throwing at Anarchy. And they should be using this Baron perhaps a little bit more aggressively right now.
Yeah, I mean, I think Mickey was a little bit worried. He canceled his recall.
He doesn't have any wards, so it's really dangerous for him to push forward. But they have to put some threat onto the Tier 2 in the top side. They come back. They tried earlier. Snowflower had to flash. They're back again. They still have about 50% of their Baron left. And
yeah,
Jinx is going to go through these turrets pretty fast.
I really feel like Mickey could sell one of his Doran's rings for a turret. Here's why. Oh, goodbye, Mickey. Enjoy your Doran's rings, fool. You could have had turrets and vision, but nope. It doesn't matter anyway. There's another inhibitor turret going down. There's another inhibitor going down. They grab him. Wow, in onto Soul. There's a box as well. Just zoning for that inhibitor. Secret comes in for the knockup. Nuclear wants to grab a kill. Soul will pick it off anyway. They'll still lose that inhibitor.
Well, nothing they could do. Spenu had to spend two people to actually make that play, and therefore pretty safe for Anarchy to just assume that the 4v3 was going to be successful at the top side. Indeed it was.
Yep.
And that is an inhibitor. So proper response from Anarchy. It doesn't really matter if Mickey dies, even though I agree he is a fool. Now, see, now he knows.
Yep.
He sold his Doran's ring and bought a ward.
What a great idea that was. Soul coming down. They want to make a play onto Ixu here. Everybody moving ahead. Some damage slowly picking away. As we see, one of the slowest chases ever that's just broken off because they don't have vision in the lower jungle.
Yep, don't want to actually go forward on that. They know that Anarchy could be lurking around that corner in the river, and indeed they are. So intelligent disengage. I mean, Soul has the Liandry's right now, but that's about it, and that's not going to be enough to actually deal the damage necessary to Ixu.
Yeah, even with those AP item buffs, Mickey in a little bit of trouble getting a gold card on to catch. Oh, who caught who? Usually it's catch being caught, that's true. They use the Ignite there, though. It's nice to get that summoner out of the way, but all the minion waves coming in. Whoa, we got him! Not even gonna get back to turret, or back to base, rather, and oh yeah, I think this one's getting pretty much over. Nice pick off by Songyun as they take down the last inhibitor. And Anarchy in prime position to take this one home. They're going onto the inhibitor turrets now, super minion waves. Going to be pushing into the bases very soon here. It's the last stand of Spenu in game number two, but I think we all assumed this was going to be going to three games. I know I did.
That seemed pretty likely, just given the caliber of these teams and they're standing right now. Not too convincing as to who is going to take the victory.
That's right. Well, I like it. All tied up. Spirit goes in, gets a two-man knockup. Ken Spen, who somehow win a team fight here. He's pretty tanky with all those stats, and they do take out Mickey. Looks like Spenu not done quite yet. Nuclear Valkyrie is ahead. Doesn't quite connect with the rocket, though. And Ixu's like, oh, guys. I was trying to split push. Oh, poked by the rocket. A lot of rockets flying around today, aren't there?
So many rockets. Jinx. Got some harpoons.
Yeah, rockets.
Some Jinx and rockets.
Well, see, in this skin, it's a rocket as well. It's not a harpoon.
It's never a harpoon. Because
that's true.
That's actually not the what a harpoon is. Do you know the Harpoon Riot? It actually has to have a rope on it to tether you to the target. A harpoon doesn't make something slower. It makes it drag you.
Uh-huh. You need to understand, though, that Riot just decides to name things. And it doesn't really matter if those names are really applicable.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
I know. That's what we've
discovered.
Dredge
line? You're throwing an anchor? Who dredges with an anchor? That's not effective at all. You're not going to catch anything with that. You know, it's just a trouble. So, it's just a problem with things that shoot other objects out.
So Riot Games, next time you make a champion, what I want you to do, so you think you have an ability name, please reach for the dictionary. Did you know the Oxford English Dictionary is also online? Just open up that tab, bookmark it, and type it in and ask, is this thing? And if it is...
Or one of its synonyms. If it is neither of those, then maybe it's time to pick a different name. Just don't name it Rat-a-tat. Here we go. Trying to make a play on a catch here. Looks like he will be caught yet again. Goodbye, Mickey, with yet another kill. Spenu in a lot of trouble. What was Catch doing up there anyway? Oh, Rocket comes through. Secret getting taken out by Jinx, and Anarchy excited to win this one. Oh, goodbye, Sasin. Lyra gets another kill there as Hecarim comes in with the ultimate nuclear. In the fountain right now, flashes away, doesn't want to die anymore. Oh, gets grabbed though, pulled right into the box, gonna Valk away, but that's the end of the game, and Anarchy takes it. We are tied up.
Yeah, and I really like that Lyra really committed to the damage Lee Sin this game.
Yes.
Had the Warrior Enchant, had the Hex Drinker, not afraid to make the deep plays to set up his team and to set up his allies. The diving was there for Anarchy, and Spenu. They just failed to respond. And that you have to be able to play against those aggressive dives, because at that point, Anarchy is taking a large risk, and you need to be able to take something else on the map, or to stuff the dive, or this happens to you.
Yeah. But
Spenu just really not reacting very well.
Indeed. Well, game number three, Picks and Bans Anarchy once again on the red side, or blue side, rather. And there's a Gragas ban. You know, I feel like as long as you keep Rek'Sai away from Catch, you've done half the job right there, and there's a Rek'Sai ban. I think they've identified that as well, too, because if you take Rek'Sai away from Catch, he can't even just right-click into the team fight and knock people up, which is pretty much all he did in game one.
Yeah, and Anarchy on this blue side again, so apparently Spenu wants a retry at the red side here. They are going to have that last pick. Will they have something better against the Twisted Fate? So Annie is going to be the ban. They want to take that away from Secret. He did get the MVP on that champion.
Yep.
So changing it up, that Kalista was banned last, and it will be TF. So, okay, Kalista and Ryze both available.
Oh, wow, and Ryze immediately taken by Ixu. That is pretty dangerous. Ixu is a pretty decent Ryze player, but what's the response going to be? Are we going to see the Fizz from Seoul? What do you think about Fizz into Ryze?
I mean, you can get stopped by the Rune Prism when you try to come in. It doesn't seem like it would be that preferable. Certainly, you can dodge the Q now since it's a skill shot with the Playful Trickster.
That is true.
You could dodge the Q and the E is, but I mean, you're just going to land on the ground, get rooted, and then that's where the Ryze combo is going to come into play.
It's interesting because Seoul really hasn't been a Fizz player this season. That's been more Ixu. Playing the Fizz up in the top lane.
Definitely. Definitely true. But in terms of other priority picks, what would you play into the Ryze here? Maokai or Rumble have been known to have some issues. They're definitely going to take the Kalista again after Nuclear's performance in that first game. And they will grab the Evelynn for the second time in a row.
All right. Well, Catch's Evelynn didn't really have any presence on the map last game. So we'll see if he can rectify that. Immediately, that Lee Sin locked in, though, for Lyra, and why not? Worked great. Yeah, grabbed the Thresh for Snowflower yet again.
Well, it's the Lee Sin Rise combo. You get one of those roots, it makes it very easy for Lee Sin to hit that sonic wave and then follow up for a high damage early kill. Spen is going to have to think long and hard about what they want in the top lane, and they also want to have the Kalista in a 2v2, which is basically seeding the 1v1 over to the Ryze. Dangerous.
I feel like you take your top and your mid here.
No.
You definitely don't
take your mid here. You really want to counterpick that. If you are a Spenu, you already used 3 bans against a mid laner. You are not going to give them the opportunity to counterpick you after that.
Okay, then. Well, Olaf would be interesting.
And the Alistar. I'm a bit surprised they didn't take that, but I guess they just want the Thresh, which Sangyun specializes with. Now, we've seen Tristana as a counterpick to the Kalista before, basically just being able to do more damage in a burst with the explosive charge rather than trying to trade with the Rend. So that's actually been successful, interestingly enough.
Yeah, Tristana locked in for Sangyun. And will it be this Victor for Mickey?
Yeah, that's what's so interesting about the Tristana.
It will.
And that was before the changes to the Kalista 2. So what happens is the Tristana can get in range, explosive shot, and they both Kalista and Tristana will auto-attack each other. But as soon as Tristana maximizes those charges, she can just rocket jump out. And at that point, she just wins the trade based on the fact that explosive charge will do more damage.
I think it looks like Sossin's thinking about the Azir here. I say just play the Ezreal, man. I know Victor's going to push you in, but you can just get the Pathfinder early and try to fight back. And Sossin's been so good on this mid-Ezreal. Like you said, most of their recent wins has been because of that Ezreal, or a large part because of that Ezreal. So when things are on the line right now, even if it's not the greatest matchup into the Victor, it seems like you go for it.
I agree with you, Doa, but I think what they're really concerned about here is the total lack of wave clear that they possess. Mm. So they're going to lock in the Azir the end. Remember, Anarchy did ban the Azir against Sossin in game one, so it is something that they've been worried about.
Yeah.
We've seen the Azir do well in lane against Victor because he has to stand in the middle of a lot of these Sand Soldiers if he wants to actually get in range for his Q, the power transfer.
Right.
So that does have some zoning capabilities. And also, they've set themselves up with a way to kind of slow down the Tristana here. Because if you're Spenu, you are really, really worried that this Tristana is going to fast push against you, especially because of the low amount of wave clear. If they pick the Ezreal, they are reliant almost entirely on True Shot Barrage and Equalizer for wave clear. And that could be rough. It's not necessarily going to go badly, but if you start having the Rebels Anarchy group against you with a Victor and a Tristana and start to 4-1 split push, you don't really have too many answers.
Sure enough. Well, we'll see if Spenu can summon the power to take their first best of three of the entire season. And again, this is really it for Spenu. It's really unlikely that they're going to have another chance like this for the rest of the season to win a match. If they lose here, I think it's going to be a winless season for them.
Yes, I think that you have to say that's going to be pretty likely. It's do or die for them. If they want to take even a single best of three, this is their best chance.
It really is. Well, it is time to get into the game, guys. Rebels Anarchy versus Spenu Sonic Boom. Who takes it? Let's get in the game and find out. Alright, welcome once again to Summoner's Rift. Spenu Sonic Boom taking on Rebels Anarchy. Both of these teams pretty hungry for a win again. 0-5 coming into this. In fact, the last time Anarchy won a best of three was against Spenu, and it was a 2-1 victory. Looking to repeat that again today. And giving Ixu that rise up in the top lane is something that Spenu may live to regret, but what do you do? That TF just manhandled them so well last game.
I know, but that shows a lot of faults with the team, right? That they're so worried about the Twisted Fate that even with the last pick for the mid lane, that they're still afraid enough because they can't adjust their play. That's basically a capitulation. It is a surrender, saying, we cannot adjust to your TF, Mickey.
Yep.
Now we have to find a different answer. It's a pretty big flaw. That's a very bad place to be in a draft.
True. Well, it's going to be a lane swap. Looks like coming out of Spenu, sending Nuclear and Secret up to that top lane. And how will this work out here? They can put a lot of pressure on the Ryze early. There is that. But will Anarchy just call it? Doesn't look like it.
Yeah, it is interesting to me that they're trying to lane swap here. Of course, you pick the Kalista for that lane dominance, but Sangyun comes up with that Tristana that we've seen do well in lane against Kalista, says, okay, we've got this pick prepared for you. And so they're going to slow down the Ryze. And since they're jungling on the weak side at the Gromp, they may have some issues when it comes to actually taking this blue buff. Q start for Ixu, so he's not going to have the Rune Prison to actually lock it down, but that's still scary, and that means that Secret just going to take a peek and then recall into the bottom side.
Yep, so Nuclear going to get a little bit of an XP boost early on, as he's going to be the only one farming up there from his team. We'll see what happens. I mean, again, if you put Kalista in a lane swap and send the support away, you kind of take away some of the utility. That Jazz and Sossin on the run already. Here comes Lear as well. Nice flay right into the gravity shield. Sossin in a lot of trouble, and he's going to go down first. Blood goes to Lyra. Great flay from Snowflower to bring him right back into the gravity field from Mickey.
I mean, I don't even know what you say to that, because they knew exactly where Lyra was on the map. They saw him coming over from the blue buff.
Yep.
Okay. And they also knew that Thresh wasn't in the bottom side. Meanwhile, Secret and Ketch had both, well, Secret had gone back to base to try and get into the bottom side, so he had no support. He was just trying to harass aggressively. All he was doing there was poking with his sand soldiers. Very questionable decision from Sossin in a situation where he had almost no information about where the enemy was, and pretty predictable that they'd be ganking him early. They have all that pressure. A Thresh and a Lee Sin, you have to be pretty confident in your ability to outplay those champions, and Sossin was only level 2.
And not a good start for Sossin at all. And continuing to get poked pretty heavily. He's going to need to play it very, very carefully for the next few minutes here.
It's just about giving up that advantage, too. I mean, it's such a silly risk to take.
Yeah.
And what you lose from it is just so much. You have to deal now with this Tristana, and the Victor being ahead means that turret can go down
a lot
faster.
Go ahead, but Pulverize. Lyra's right there, though. Secret taking a lot of damage. Here we go. Exhaustion's on Sangyun as he comes in. The flash used by Secret just to get himself out of there. Use the exhaust as well, too. So
there's just so much damage from the Lee Sin and the Tristana early.
Yep.
I have to be very respectful of that all-in potential.
Yeah, Spenu already getting pushed back pretty heavily across lanes.
So Mickey chunks out this turret. If Sangyun gets a little bit of free time on the tower now because they are doing the damage. Notice how Lyra's just staying in the lane right now, helping to push it up. They know that they've got, they control the tempo of this game now. They can just go ahead, continue to push this tower, try and get their edges that way, and they're going to buy a lot of time for Ixu in the top side.
That's right. Ixu looking for a jungler. Catchy is up there, but looks like he's going to turn back around again. Pretty massive CS lead in mid lane, too, that Mickey's acquired over Sossin already. Nearly doubling his CS at 5 minutes. Wow.
Yeah, this is a very rough situation. But, you know, the Azir will be able to farm safely as long as he plays back. His barrier's almost back up, so he does have a little bit of peace of mind. But Anarchy now knows that Evelynn was in their jungle on the top side, and Mickey just continuing to push up. Mickey has that pink ward on the bottom side. He's going to know if Evelynn is there. He knows that Evelynn is up in the river right now,
yep,
just due to the direction she ran after the wolves, so he backs off.
And he can certainly afford to do it, too.
Yeah. Mickey just playing this lane much better so far.
Oh, Lear's going to find another turret right before it dies, but still gets a little bit of gold.
ward.
Alsasa needs to be, yeah, those jungle turrets, you know, gotta watch out. Well, Lyra's right there again. They've got a pink ward, so they know he can't come in. Chaos Storm used Sossin. He's dead again. Lyra with another kill.
Yeah, I thought Lyra should have gotten the MVP in the last game. He really is making the plays on the map with the Lee Sin. Has those double long swords, so he's powered up. You have to play very respectfully around him right now because he's got way more damage than he should for 6 minutes into this game. And that was pretty easy. I mean, Lyra didn't have to blow his flash. Mickey still with both summoners. Hardly any investment whatsoever.
Yeah. I mean, Sossin, it's just so dangerous for him to do any sort of farming at all. He can't even push halfway up his lane right now. He did kind of get himself caught, you know, in the wall that is by the river, I guess. So, got to put himself there.
What do you do right now if you're Spenu? You're in a really tenuous situation. Catch is going to get grabbed.
Yeah, and again, tons of damage from that Lee Sin. Another easy kill. Ignite used by Snowflower just to secure it. Lyra 3-0-0 now.
Wow,
oh boy, this might be a fast one.
They're going after this blue buff even though Victor isn't in the mid lane. They've got the support already, so this is a very unusual situation that they're going to take advantage of. Sol has to stay there. Of course, that Tristana hasn't shopped yet, so she doesn't have much damage, but even then, Spenu not confident enough to actually interrupt this play. Now they're going to try and bait out. Nope, they're going to just recall. They might have been trying to be cute and wait for the Evelynn to check the blue, but that's not going to happen.
Yeah, well, Q missed, but Nuclear still taking a lot of damage. Man, if that Q had hit, he flashes in. Oh, Nuclear still alive, though.
There was nothing for the E to bounce to right there. He was just a little bit too far away.
Now, Catch doing a little bit of responding damage to Mickey, but really nothing to speak of. Yeah, if that one Q had hit that Ixu missed, would have been able to get the kill on the Nuclear, but Nuclear was able to use the summoner heal to get out.
Yeah, that was a flash burn for a heal, though.
Yeah.
And now Rumble right back in top lane. Has that Haunted Guise already. Just a tier for Ixu so far, but Ixu getting to that point where the all-in potential is still going to be pretty deadly from the rise, especially if this extremely high damage Lee Sin hits the top lane. There are no resists, there's no armor from Sol. He will go down quite fast.
Pretty much Chaos Storm used. Sossin has to flash away. Looks like he'll make it out, but I would trade an ultimate for a flash. It's not a bad trade at all. Got the barrier, too. Actually, no, the barrier was just coming up still from the last time they used it, it looks like.
And you're going to get some damage down onto the tower. They are just dictating the pace of this game.
Yeah.
Anarchy just playing, pressing out as far as they can. The aggression that they won in the mid lane, that first blood, has translated into a game where Ketch really doesn't have very many lanes to go after here. There's no hard crowd control to block down the rise in the top side, so that's not a very good gank option. If Sol had been playing something like Maokai in this game, at least they would have more kill pressure onto the rise. But I mean, Sol's coming up here again. He's been up here before, and Ixu has not been bothered whatsoever.
Yeah. I mean, it's not even 10 minutes into the game, and Anarchy already has total control over the map. Comes Catch. Looks like they're going to nearly bait him in there. Waiting for the passive to fall off. He did use his ultimate, too. Yeah, they're just... What's going to stop? I mean, he has no flash. They're going to have to do a lot of damage, but he's not going.
I mean, there's no damage either. They only have one longsword onto the Evelynn.
That was going to be, like, their best chance to make a play there, though, and they didn't go for it. I feel like at this point, you know, why not go for it? It's not like Mickey's going to push in any less, you know?
You probably guess, too, that Lyra is going to be hovering around his red buff at this time.
Yeah.
So, but Lyra just goes from the red buff, pops into the dragon pit. They already have that lane pushed up. Sagi and Stoneflower, they're there. The Azir is pinned to his mid lane at the moment. Victor has that priority in terms of responding over to the dragon. So first dragon easily taken pretty early here at 10 minutes by Anarchy.
Whoa, pushing Mickey back into the turret. They may be able to get themselves a kill here. It looks like they will. Chaos Storm doing a lot. No, he gets on the lantern. Whoa, and then a flash Q from Lyra. Are you kidding me? Wow. Well, things could not go any worse if you are spinning right now.
No, they could not. Anarchy just showing that on an individual level, they are superior players, especially
really
when it comes to the jungle mismatch. And that is a beautiful hook.
How many times have I said this before? Catch got caught. Secret will get out. He's got that ultimate.
Okay, solo kill in the top side.
Yeah, why not? This game's
There's
over. Pack
tower.
It up, guys. This is a finish best of three at this point.
The manor slash dance next to Soul's corpse. I love it. I love your attitude, Iksu.
Yes. Yes.
That's right. Showboat a little. Makes it fun.
It's a beautiful thing. Well.
All right.
Let's watch this one again. Because initially it looks pretty good.
Yeah. Mickey gets bounced back. He misses his death ray as a result of that play from Sasan, but Songyun gets in there and Snowflower follows up with a hook on to Catch. They use the rocket jump immediately and the ignite just to get some damage.
Catch decides, hey man, I'll just stick around. Nothing bad will happen to me, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, and Snowflower, we often see the Thresh banned. He is a very good Thresh player. He does make plays on the mid lane and he gets Mickey ahead. And look what's happening now, TP.
Yeah, well, it looks like they're going to play Sasan in again. Nice death sentence from Snowflower, and that is Sasan dead for the fourth time this game already.
Snowflower is making the plays this game. You can't take that away from him. Guy is doing work.
7-0 right now. We could easily have a perfect game on our hands.
But look at the wards. There's pink wards on either side of the mid lane. Sasan has he has nothing to work with here.
Yeah, well, he has no turret to work with either.
He has no turret to work with. There's deep wards on one side. There's pink wards on both sides of the river. They're going to try and hunt Mickey
exhaust.
In.
Yeah, Mickey getting very, very low. Looks like this might be the moment. Gravity field doing a lot of damage, though. No, it's not. Catch is going to keep chasing. Lyra comes in, and Catch in trouble again. The Q misses, but there's the death ray, and Lyra picks up yet another one onto Soul. Your soul is mine.
I love seeing this carry Lee Sin. Look at this. He's going for a phage.
This is insane.
It makes me miss Lee Sin so much as a meta jungler, because I know people were always saying, Lee Sin's so boring. We see him every game, and why are we? I'm glad we have this new jungle meta. Well, I like the new jungle meta too, but Lee Sin is just so fun to watch, and it makes
me. I never minded Lee Sin.
I like the fact that we can have a mix of damage and tank junglers.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh, here comes the Black Cleaver.
The Black Cleaver Lee Sin is on the way. And another turret.
And when you have 5 kills, you might as well just go for offensive items. I love this mentality.
Yep.
I wish we had more junglers that would do this.
Yeah.
Just if you're a jungler in the head and you're ahead, use your presence on the map. Use the fact that you are an unknown factor. And you don't have to group up or play traditionally.
Oh, hi.
You have Lantern. Long Jeez. Lantern right there.
Thought they were going to try to catch again. He's got to change his name. If he sticks around, if he's still a pro player next year, he better have a different ID. That's all I gotta say. The only thing he's allowed to change it to that is even remotely close is caught. Now wards, they do spot Snowflower coming in, but things are bad, real bad for Spenny right now.
Well, your prophecy was a lie, Della.
I guess so. You know, it was their best chance, but they're just not playing very well.
Well, they only get one good game a series. They're like Samsung.
So
Samsung will impress you one game.
So true. And Anarchy this series is looking better than they've looked in a while, too. It's looking much tighter. And it's looking tighter because they're getting a ton of kills early, but still. All right. Ult used. There's a nice equalizer. Slows down Mickey and Lyra, but that's a Karas Storm. The Seeker comes in with a big knockup. Gets pushed out by the Lee Sin kick, though. Mickey manages to get a kill anyway. Nobody going down. Here comes Soul. Can they get Snowflower? Looks like they will. 2 kills finally for Spenu, but they still lose Catch.
So you probably shouldn't be walking into the enemy jungle
people
when you don't really know where people are. And you also have a teleport disadvantage. Iksu still has his down. Souls was available. So that was a very cocky play. Could have instead made a play onto the top tier 1. Now they're going to lose a mid turret for sure. Lyra's not going to be enough. Trading tier 1 for tier 1, though.
All right.
That's Tristana.
Well, it is a turret, so it's not going to be a perfect game. They got some kills. They got a turret. Dragging up in a minute. And all the kills, nearly all the kills on this Lee Sin, if the game goes late enough, may come back to haunt Anarchy.
Possible, yes.
Anarchy needs to keep the momentum up.
Yes, they do. But fortunately for Anarchy, they also have Ryze. And that late game Ryze. Yeah, the Tristana. It's just the speed of pushing that Tristana gives you. And you can just use Mickey's Chaos Storm to zone people off the tower and simply just have Trisano auto-attack with that explosive shot. So pretty easy when it comes to actually cracking the base. It's a great team composition to do that with.
Fair enough.
Black Cleaver done for Lyra. Oh boy.
Oh boy. Wow, we're really on the same wavelength today, aren't we?
Ixu just going to not recall, I guess, in the Tri-Brush. He's been standing in a ward for about the past minute.
Oh, it's gone now. He waited till it died of natural causes. A ward lived a long and happy life. Dragon's up, and Anarchy really wants to make this their second of the game. Can they get it? Uh-oh. Hello.
Catch has been found.
Yep. And uses that W to try to get away. Gets flayed. Mickey right there as well. Makes it back to his team. And meanwhile, Lyra just takes the dragon, because why not? Whoa. They try to go in. Catch makes it. No, doesn't make it out. Sagiun with the flash ult.
The flash buster shot for the finisher right there. Following him through his own flash. So some good damage down. Sagiun figuring, why not? I could just flash forward for this one.
Man, I think I've had better Evelynn games than this.
Ketch has truly been a non-factor in this series.
Well, he's been worse than a non-factor. He's been a detrimental factor to the team.
Well, I mean, especially in the laning phase, it's hard to shut him down now. There's nothing Ketch can do when all of the lanes are so far ahead on Anarchy.
Yeah.
So at this stage, what do you do? You try and
stop Ixu. Try to throw Secret in there and make a play, but Ixu just flashes. Secret has his flash. Not going to go for it, though.
Yeah. Too risky to actually go for it. You're not going to gain that much by chasing Ryze down this lane. And
no
by
vision.
Investing so many people into the bottom side, well, Tristana's going to do what Tristana does and get a lot of turret damage down. There's the explosive charge. Yep, here we go. Lots of damage. That turret's dead for sure. Total vision control to Anarchy at the moment. They've got pink wards in some nice places in the enemy jungle.
Yeah, well, trying to make a play again. Snowfire's going to flash out of that one. That Chaos Storm does so much damage, pulling Sossin right back into it. Mickey gets knocked up, and they're going to be able to take Snowflower. Spenu turning this one around. There goes Mickey. Two kills for Spenu, but they have to get away before everybody else gets there.
And Anarchy, they didn't want to actually commit to the Ryze TP, interestingly enough.
I guess so, yeah.
As another two kills come in. Huh. And also what happened there was while the fight was going on, we saw Lyra and Ixu and Sangyun start to move through the jungle into the mid lane, but then go back. If they had actually just pushed up to the inhibitors right there, they may have been able to break up Anarchy, just a little bit sooner. It was a bit indecisive.
Sure enough.
But Anarchy has all the information. If they see people grouping up as four, they need to be more cautious. You don't want to accidentally throw this game and give the enemy team a Baron. It's going to spawn in less than a minute.
Yeah, but even if Spenu won a team fight, would they even be able to take Baron at this point? I suppose with Kalista, they probably could, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
They have Liandry's Torment too, so
true.
And also Azir. So yeah, they definitely have the tools to get a Baron. It wouldn't be a clean one or a very fast one with their lack of items, but if you get enough kills and you have that window where you could take it uncontested, it's still a possibility.
Sasa going for the Nashor's Tooth build on this Azir as well too. I mean, Nashor's Tooth does have a little bit more AP in 513. And
yeah, it's definitely a better pickup now than it was in 512 onto Azir.
Buy it on Lulu if you're support. I recommend. For those sick auto attack trades. Nothing?
Nope.
Okay.
I got nothing. That's your thing. The sick auto attack traits on Lulu.
Yeah.
Just using that passive over and over and over again.
I'll take your silence as an agreement.
You do that.
I will. Well, Anarchy back out for the moment. Baron is up and 9,000 gold lead right now. Rebels Anarchy. Spenu was able to get a few more wards out after winning that little scuffle in the mid lane, but not really anything near Baron. Oh, hello. Oh, Sangyun could be in trouble here. Are they going to bother throwing him in? Nah. Rocket jump's pretty good.
Yes, yes it is. Very nice disengage tool. Meanwhile, Ixu is getting very, very close to having a Seraph's Embrace. We're getting to Scary Rise territory. He should be fully powered up by about 25, 26 minutes. And that, they just don't have an answer. Who's gonna stop him from split pushing right now? Soul, if he gets close, will just be all in.
And there goes the mid lane tier two. Man, only the bot lane left and it has like no health left.
Got nothing, so. Anarchy doing a great job of snowballing this game very quickly. They've been pushing their advantage as well, continuing to get these towers. And this is what I was concerned about, Dilla, the lack of wave clear. If Anarchy got ahead, that Tristana can just split push by herself. She's very safe, has a long range escape, has a buster shot, and is absolutely devastating on those turrets. So when you only have an Azir for the wave clear, and imagine here if they had a sun, the Pulsefire the Rune Wave Ezreal, that really wouldn't have been doing them very many favors either. They would have even had less wave clear.
True.
And less defensive capability, because at least they have Azir turrets to stop the push a little bit.
Very little bit.
Yeah, Anarchy's major lead early has been very helpful, because now Anarchy can just 1-3-1 split push, and that's what they've been doing. It's allowed them to get up four towers in the lead, and now this Baron can go down pretty much at any time. They have the Rise to deal the damage.
Yeah, and Spenu just needs multiple miracle team fights at this point. Azir turret dragging up in about 10 seconds now. And are they actually going to try to make a pick on Ixu? If they do, that dragon is basically Anarchy's. Oh, nuclear. The pick is on him. Just gets destroyed by that Rise.
Yeah, just hiding in the brush there. One single rotation of spells takes him out pretty much. Maybe just a little bit more. A second Q perhaps. Slipped
horrifying.
In there, but that is about the strength of Rise at this stage.
Catch and Seeker right there, too. They wanted to try to make a play, but it just didn't happen. The timing was off.
Well,
there goes the Azir turret.
If you're Catch and Seeker, you definitely can't make a play under the Rise after that. He can easily 1v2 you.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, they were supposed to come in with nuclear, you know, but did not expect Ixu to be that aggressive, I guess. I don't know. It was weird. Well, there goes that turret.
Nice buster
shot.
Buster
shotting secret away, yeah. Whoa, that was brave and kind of dumb. Exhaust, the flash used, and Songin will get taken out. There's a kill for nuclear.
Lyra's still here. He's just going to hop over the wall, so Anarchy.
Oh, Songin.
They're playing a little bit too aggressive. Obviously, they've given up some deaths that they didn't have to, but in the end, they still end up taking a turret every single time, so it's sort of hard to fault them because they're getting the major objectives. And with the death timer so low, because it's very early into this game, there's not really that much threat behind just having Songyun die right there. At
sure.
The very least, now you crack the base. That is definitely, if there's no punishment on Songyun dying right there, it's absolutely worth it to trade that one kill for an inhibitor turret, because you can just come back in 20 seconds and re-siege it and get it for sure then. And now that's something that Spenu has to worry about for the rest of the game. Or is this big stacked minion wave, a slow push wave, going to hit that inhibitor and take it out?
Right.
Is somebody going to backdoor it? So certainly a worthwhile trade, I think, especially since Spenu couldn't reciprocate in any way whatsoever.
Yeah, pretty much. Still 11,000 gold down, and I mean, it's... there's just not a lot they can do. It's going to need to be like a big, like you said, catastrophic fight to Baron or something like that, but it seems unlikely.
Well, how are you going to get that now? So here's the next problem. They're assigning their lanes well, which means that Songyun's at the top side. We have the 1-3-1. There's a Rise going into the bottom lane right now. Okay, well, Rise is now threatening your inhibitor. It doesn't even have to go through the tower. Who's going to 1v1 the Rise? Absolutely nobody.
Yep.
Is the answer.
Think about making a pick with this red buff. They've got vision there. But no, not pulling the trigger on that one.
So Anarchy wise to just play it here. Basically, if it's just Rumble down there, Rumble dies. If they see more than two people there, then it's a Baron for Anarchy. Just a matter of playing it patiently right now.
Yep, they're going to go for that Baron. It's going to die really fast too. Here comes Spenu.
They're doing this early. They should have waited for Rise.
They have to stop it. It is a bit dangerous. Yeah, they're going to have to back off from that one.
That's really silly from Anarchy. They can totally just wait this out. They do not have to go after the Baron this fast. Here's where you start thinking about threatening the Baron when this is happening.
Right, because here comes Spenu.
And now you sit there and you see three people. Now you Baron, right now.
Yeah, they're going for it. Can they catch Ixu, though? There's Equalizer. There's a Flash. I don't even think they can catch him. No, he's giving up a Baron. Catch right there. Counting on catch for the miracle Baron steal, but Mickey's probably going to take him out before he gets a chance. He's running away from the mid laner now. Has to get away. There's a gravity field, and catch can't even get close. Even try to steal this Baron. Easy Baron for Team Anarchy.
Yep, that's how you do it. They jump the gun a little bit before, not the cleanest shot calling, but they do figure out their problem and get the right call in the end. So there's your Baron. And now you go back to 1-3 splitting, 1-3-1 splitting, because there's still nobody who can deal with Ixu. He didn't die, has the Baron buff right now, has a chance to go recall, pick up some more items, and make that final push.
Pretty much.
GA, going to be next for Ixu, it would appear.
Yeah, it looks like going to be Randuin's for Lyra once he finishes that item up.
Interesting that we see a Hex Drinker on Dasong here. Not really sure why he will need that.
I guess maybe just to fight Rumble and Azir close up, perhaps?
I mean, okay, that's fair. It is good in the split push capacity where he might be against the Rumble in a 1v1.
Yeah. Well, it's too bad to see Spenu dismantled so completely after a pretty promising end of the game, number one. Looks like they might catch Ixu here, but we'll see how strong this Ryze is right now. Not taking a lot of damage yet. There's a knockup. There's the exhaust goes in on a nuclear. Looks like he's not going to get a lot of damage. Man, they committed a lot to that, but they got the kill. Are they going to lose their mid inhibitor? Soul on the run now. There's Equalizer. Oh, Mickey taking a lot of turret damage. Getting very, very low.
So do they have time with the Tristana to take the inhibitor is the question. It's going to be close.
Yeah, we'll see. Equalizer already used, though, so that takes away a lot of Spinner's engage here. Look at that. The damage onto Soul is going to be big. There's a knockup onto Lyra. Catch coming in. Is he going to use his ult? Nope, saving it for now. So it looks like they will save their inhibitor as Snowflower doesn't connect with that death sentence.
Well, they just didn't have enough wards in top lane, and they were. What happened there was Anarchy was applying that pressure unevenly. They hadn't pushed up enough in the bottom side or in the mid lane to actually threaten the inhibitor, which meant that it gave Spenu enough time to just walk into top lane. So by the time the enemy minion wave reached the bottom side, you need to actually, when you're trying to split push, you have to put the pressure on evenly. Otherwise, it gives the enemy too much time to collapse onto one lane and then just back off like we saw there. And it stalls out your entire pushing. Have to wait for Ixu to come back at that point, and you end up wasting a lot of your Baron.
Pretty much. Man, Lyra's been so good this game. And that inhibitor, already nearly dead. In fact, it will go down. Anarchy just walking up and taking that one, and wow, this game is pretty much over, unless we see Spenu go for a pretty incredible fight right here.
It's going to be a close one for sure in terms of whether this Baron buff's already gone. Never mind. Thought they might have it on the next siege, but they're not going to.
Does it really matter? That's the question. Doesn't look like it does so far.
Well, Tristana is kind of trying to flank.
Oh,
right
going
there.
In. Nice play by Secret. Gets the engage. Can they win a team fight here? Snowflower grabs Sasan. There's a mid laner dead already. Nuclear gets locked up, tries to back away. And now the Chaos Storm kind of taking a ride, but they're going to catch Soul anyway. This fight is definitely not going Spenu's way. And that is going to be about that. Nuclear and catch, the only one standing between Anarchy and a 2-1 victory. And I don't think that's going to be enough.
Nope, not at this stage. This is Anarchy just rolling their way through this second game. They have a massive advantage. They played some aggressive League of Legends, some perhaps risky League of Legends, but they were not punished. Had some good dives in games 2 and 3, and that's how they're going to win this one.
Yep, that is it. And so it ends just like the last series does. Anarchy 2-1 over Spenu Sonic Boom.
Wow. Well, I mean, Anarchy came to play, and I think when they realized in game one, because if we take a look at game one, they were outplaying Spenu in the laning phase, and then they dropped the ball. They started getting picked off. They started playing more reserved, and I think they realized that if they could just consistently attempt to outplay Spenu on the map, just try and force these skirmishes over and over and over again,
yeah,
that they just had more skill and would win off of that alone, and as well as Ketch not really having much presence, and Soul
well,
not really being there with the TPs, honestly.
Those two.